Selenium dioxide. Here in this video we are going to discuss selenium dioxide, which is used as an oxidizing agent. But this is not just oxidizing agent, this is chemoselective oxidizing agent. You remember chemoselective oxidizing agent, it selects particular site of the molecule for the oxidation. So it is very, very useful oxidizing agent. Otherwise, if you use another oxidizing agent like KMnO4, that oxidizing agent is not chemoselective. It oxidizes the whole molecule and sometimes there is a breaking of bonds. So to avoid such accidents or such type of unlimited oxidation reaction, we have to select selenium dioxide. So because of that, we call it as a chemoselective oxidizing agent, because it oxidizes active methyl or methylene group. Methyl means CH2 and CH2. Methyl means CH3 and methylene means CH2. So it can oxidize CH3 or CH2 group, but it should be active. Active means it should have electron withdrawing group, at least this carbonyl group. If electron withdrawing group is there, we can say these hydrogens are more acidic. So this is active methylene or methyl group. So what is important? So this selenium oxide selects either methyl or methylene group, which are active, means which are having at least electron withdrawing group like carbonyl group, for the oxidation. Another important reaction is it can select allylic group. Allylic B is the group attached to this group. This group is called allylic group, means this is double bonded carbon, next carbon is allylic carbon. So this carbon is selected for the oxidation. So because of this, we can say this is chemoselective oxidizing agent. Here I have given few examples. You can see this methylene group is active methylene group. We can remove this proton because of acidity, more acidity. And you can see there is a carbonyl group attached. So there are three hydrogens. So when this compound is treated with selenium dioxide, what happens? Two hydrogens are removed. Two hydrogens are removed. And these two hydrogens are actually taking the position of, these hydrogens are removed and the oxygen is taking the position of that two hydrogens. So you can see one hydrogen is there and one oxygen is attached with a double bond, and these two hydrogens combine with oxygen to form H2O, and this is selenium. So in this way you can introduce another carbonyl group at the adjacent carbon, at the alpha carbon. So this is glyoxide. This glyoxide is produced. Here I have taken another example. Instead of acetaldehyde, if you take acetone, again you are going to remove two hydrogens and form water, and at the place of two hydrogen you have to join oxygen with a double bond. So this is selected. So oxygen is attached to this carbon, to this alpha carbon, with the help of two bonds, and these two hydrogens are removed to form water, and in this way we get here 2-oxopropanol. So this 2-oxopropanol is produced, where we are introducing a carbonyl group at alpha carbon. So either these or these, both are identical, both are symmetrical, both are similar groups. So you can select either these or these, but you have to just introduce oxygen, where oxygen is joined with the help of two bonds, means carbonyl group you have to introduce. Similarly, if it is cyclohexanone, you select alpha carbon, either these or these, you can select any one of these, and join oxygen with the help of two bonds. So I join oxygen with the help of two bonds, or you may select this carbon because both are alpha. So one oxygen is joined with the help of two bonds, means at alpha position there is carbonyl group along with formation of selenium and water. So in this way oxidation takes place. This is very different. If you are using KMnO4, it is very difficult to stop that reaction here or introduce oxygen at alpha carbon. It is not possible. Now, what happens with allylic group? With the allylic group, you have to perform hydroxylation. Means you are going to join OH group. Hydroxylation means you are joining OH group at allylic carbon. So this carbon, as I mentioned earlier, is a allylic carbon. So either this or this is allylic carbon. Or this is also allylic carbon. But now, when you perform hydroxylation of allylic carbon, you have to select highly substituted end of the double bond. So this is highly substituted end of the double bond, because there are two substituents and you have to select a methyl group, either these or these, both are identical. Remove one hydrogen and join OH at the place of one hydrogen. So there are three hydrogens, one hydrogen is removed and the hydroxyl group is introduced. So this is called hydroxylation, and since this is allylic carbon, so this is called hydroxylation of allylic carbon. So in this way, you can introduce hydroxyl group here. Similarly, I have taken one more example. So you have to select this end because this is highly substituted end, and in which either this or this is selected, but this highly substituted carbon is selected. So remove this. Highly substituted end is selected. So this one hydrogen is removed. I forgot to mention one hydrogen there. So you have to remove one hydrogen and introduce one OH. So in this way, you can perform allylic hydroxylation. So selenium dioxide is used either for the oxidation of active methyl or methylene group, or for oxidation of allylic carbon, where we introduce hydroxyl group. And in case of methyl, active methyl or methylene group, we introduce carbonyl group. So this is all about selenium dioxide. Thank you.